So early on in statistics, you start to learn things like central tendency and variability. So mean and standard deviation are examples of those. What this means is you're going to have to do a lot of calculations by hand, and they quickly become tedious. So with standard deviation, you're going to take your numbers and you're going to minus them by your mean, and that's represented here. So you're going to take each of these numbers and you're going to minus it by the mean. Now, when you're doing this on a calculator, it gets pretty annoying if you're doing, problem after problem after problem. And something that I always advocate for is lots of practice. With statistics, unfortunately, you're going to have to practice a lot to be able to do these not only well, but fast as well, which is one part of passing a stats exam, is to be able to do it confidently and quickly. So the issue with that is you know how to do one number minus another number. So when you're doing this to get your standard deviation, maybe it's not that part where you're taking your x minus your mean that really you need practice with. So is there a way to skip that step? And the answer is yes, and the answer is Excel. Now, I'm a stats tutor for undergraduate students, and I'm surprised how often people don't know that Excel can do this. So I thought I'd share it with you in case you don't know. So I'm going to take these numbers here. I'm going to put it on X, but let's first read this problem before we start working with those numbers. Now, yeah, statisticians are trying to be quirky, so here's a quirky example for you. Every day, Jack goes to the river to catch tadpoles. When he gets home, he puts them into his pond so that they can grow into frogs. He believes that if he can train them from birth, that they will one day do his chores for him. Below are how many tadpoles Jack has caught in the last 10 days. What is the mean number and standard deviation of tadpoles that Jack adds to his little army each day? So, what we need to do is just to discern what the standard deviation and mean are. So, with our mean, I'm not going to get too much into the concepts of what these are, but basically, we add these numbers together and then we divide by our total count. So, we have 10 different days, so we're going to add these together and then divide by 10. Now, we could do that by hand, of course. Or we can use Excel to do that, but it also in it like by hand as well. So I could go, 3 plus 5 plus 7 and so forth. But I'm not gonna, because what I can do is use a function in Excel called average. So if I put equals, and the equals is very important, it says we're gonna start using these mathematical manipulations. We click average and it says, well, what do you want to average? So we just highlight what we want to average. And there's our new average, 4.7. Or not our new average, our first average. So our mean is 4.7. So what that means is, based on these numbers, Jack gets 4.7 on average tadpoles each day. Now with standard deviation, what we're going to do is we're going to do the rest by hand. So the first step is to do x minus the mean. So 3 minus 4.7, for example. Then we're going to square that number, and then we're going to sum it for sums of squared, then we're going to divide it by our 10 here for variance, and then we're going to square root it for standard deviation. Now, if I'm going too fast, it's fine. We're going to go through that. The problem here is if you're doing this by hand over and over again because you're practicing so much, because with stats you need to be practicing, there's different parts that you need to work on, and that's usually not here. So taking 3 minus 4.7 is usually not what you need to work on. That's something you can do easily. So let's try and skip that step by doing it in Excel. So what we're going to do is we're going to hit equal, take this number, and we're going to minus it by our mean. Now I'm going to put a dollar sign on the before the G and before the 2. Now you'll see the blue is this blue number here, and the red's the mean over here. Now on the top is columns, and they're in letters, and on the side is rows, and they're in numbers. So dollar sign just means that this red one won't move across columns and won't move across rows either. Now, it's not too important what that means for now. So I'm gonna hit enter. So what we know is 3 minus 4.7 is negative 1.7. Okay, cool. Now, if we're doing this by hand, we're gonna have to do it again for this next one. But because Excel is great, what I'm gonna do is there's this little square here. I'm gonna click it and drag it down. Now what this does is it does all my computations for me. So now, if I weren't talking so much, I could have done this in about 1 second. Then furthermore, I could take these numbers now, and you see these are the deviations. Now we're going to square them. I'm going to take this number and put a little top hat there, and then I'm going to put 2, and that just means squared by 2, or the exponent of 2. So now, negative 1.7 is 3 minus 4.7, and then we square it. And of course, we could do the same thing where we pull it down, and these are all our squared numbers. Now, if you know a bit about standard deviation, the next step is getting our sums of squares. So these are our squared deviations, and all sums of squares is saying is we've got to sum them together. So let's add them together. Now there's a function in Excel called sum, and then we can add them all together. And now our sums of squared is 62.1. Our variance is going to be this number divided by the total number of observations we have. Now we could easily do this by just taking this and divided by 10. We could just put 10 in there. Or we can use the count function, which just counts how many things are in an area. So if I just drag over here, there's 10 different things, so that's what it's going to tell me. And it's going to do, you know, this number, this sums of squared, divided by how many numbers are there. And then we're going to hit enter, and that's 6.21. Now our standard deviation, the last step to change from variance to standard deviation, is to square root it. So we're going to hit equals, and then SQRT. And then we're going to click that, and then there is our standard deviation. So we've done everything to get our mean and our standard deviation. Now again, the point of this is not to cheat through your homework, because yes, you could have done this and gotten all the right answers, but then you're going to fail the test. But it's to be able to skip the parts that you don't need practice with. So for example, if you really have trouble going from this sums of squared to the variance to the standard deviation, but you have no problem with this part of it, you can easily just automatically calculate this stuff and then really just practice this stuff over here without having to do all this tedious, time-consuming work. More than that, you can also check your answers as you go. One of the most common issues I see with people's answers when they're doing homeworks or even tests and stuff is they do some minor miscalculation here. And I know one thing minus another is easy, but when you're doing it and you're annoyed because you don't want to do it in the first place and you're just rushing through it, you make mistakes. So what you could do is you could do this by hand, then check and make sure your numbers match these numbers. Because if one of these numbers are wrong, everything else down the line is going to be wrong too. So go through it and then check your numbers and then move to the next column. Do those by hand, then check your numbers, and then keep going. And it's a good way to keep on track and making sure that if you're making a mistake, it's just a minor calculation mistake, and it's not because you didn't understand how to do it in the first place. Because I see a lot of students getting really frustrated because they're like, I thought I knew what I was doing, but I'm getting it wrong, what's going on? And we just find out it's just this number is wrong, something like that. Additionally, what happens is professors only have so much time. So they give you a few different questions to practice on. You do them once or twice each, and then you can't really keep redoing them because you know what the answers are. So you start going in this motion where you want more practice questions. Now, Excel gives you a really good opportunity to do that yourself. So I could just randomly put these numbers in, or different numbers in here, which I'll do right now. So if I say the last 10 days, Jack caught these many tadpoles. Okay, so this is a whole new set of numbers. I'm going to copy these into this X column here. And what you'll notice is everything updated automatically. So now you could just add these new sets of numbers that you randomly generate yourself, and then you already have your answer key to check after. So if you don't want to see it right away, then just, you know, block it out or whatnot, and then do everything by hand and then see if you match the same answers that they had. And if so, great. And this is just another way to be able to practice without having to go search the internet for new practice problems. You just need a new set of numbers that you can just generate yourself.